Hi, I'm Kathy Cote from Katalyst Fitness and Nutrition, right here in Mashpee. I'd like to bring you a five-part series covering weight loss, or Weight Loss 101. We'll go over exercise, diet, and a couple things that you might not think are related to weight loss. Thank you for watching Mashpee TV. This is a five-part series on weight loss. So first off, let's define weight loss and fat loss. I think it's important to distinguish the difference. I want to focus on fat loss for my online clients, not just seeing a number go down on the scale. And this will vary depending on gender and age and your body composition or the amount of body fat and muscle mass that you currently have. Hormones will also have a significant role in energy regulation and how we store fat on our bodies. When cortisol is high, we will store that weight around our middle, as this is where the cortisol receptors are. Another form of weight loss is water loss. This is typically seen in a ketogenic diet approach. As you eliminate carbs from your diet, your body releases the glycogen stored in your muscles, which is in the form of water. It's not unusual to lose 5 to 8 pounds of water weight pretty quickly, but this will come back as you introduce carbs back into the diet, refilling the glycogen stores in your muscles. Rather than focusing on weight loss, the real goal should be to preserve as much muscle as possible while losing as much fat as possible. You can expect on average to lose 1% to 3% of your body fat per month, or 0.25 to 0.75% per week. So let's take a 160-pound woman. It's realistic to expect fat loss to be anywhere from 0.4 to 1.2 pounds per week, or 1.6 to 4.8 pounds per month. She could go on a very low-calorie diet and lose 2 pounds a week, but unfortunately, not all that weight loss is going to be fat. She'd also be losing some muscle as well. And with that rate of weight loss, she'd have to go into a pretty significant calorie deficit in the long run. Or even short term, this isn't sustainable. And this is going to lead to weight gain after the diet, and possibly more than she started with, since she's also lost muscle mass. As she brings more calories on, they are going to be stored as fat, and that muscle is gone. This is why it's so hard to lose weight each time you do another diet. It's called the yo-yo effect. Dieting is a stress on the body, and your body wants to preserve its fat sources, and it sees the muscle on your frame as an expensive tissue to keep on its body. Muscle burns calories, so if you're under-consuming calories well below maintenance to lose weight, it will start offloading that muscle. Since the goal is fat loss and not weight loss in the form of fat and muscle, this would not be advantageous to your physique and health in the long run. Next time, we're going to be talking about which is more effective for fat loss, diet or exercise. Thank you for watching Mashpee TV.